Today, I'm getting window coverings for the whole house. This is the fabric I chose for these windows. Ooh, that's pretty. Does it come in orange? I think orange curtains would look great in here. We all know orange is your favorite color. For sneak peeks and behind the scenes of our videos, follow us on our Facebook page, Rosie's World. In this video, I'm going to show you how to make quick and easy window coverings for dollhouses. I took a window out of the house to make it easier to show you what I'm doing. These are scrapbook paper that I pre-cut to make the shades. These are some square dowels that I cut to fit the window. You don't really need them to make shades, but I like using them. To attach the dowel rod to the window frame, I'll be using this magnetic strip. It has a sticky side, but it doesn't stick very well. I still have to hot glue it on. To measure how much magnetic strip to cut, I just stick it to the dowel and cut. Ooh, that piece just fell off. Stick it back on. Put one in the middle. And one more at the end. And I'll need pieces on the window frame. This is the tricky part, because magnets are polarized. Opposite sides attract, and same sides repel. See this piece here? It doesn't sit directly on top. Now, if I turn it around, it fits perfectly on top. I'll show you again. This one fits perfectly, but if I turn it the other way, it just doesn't want to line up. Turn it around and it's perfect. Last piece. Try both ways if you're not sure. It'll just look right and feel right. Now to glue it on the frame. Oops, major boo-boo here. I hot glued it to the wrong side of the window frame. This is the outside. I'll have to fix it later. Let's continue. Now to glue the magnets to the dowel. Let's start with this pretty paper. Make a clean top edge by folding it down about a centimeter. This makes the edge more sturdy. Place a folded edge above the dowel and mark how long you want the shade to be. I want it this long, but I'm going to make a fold higher up. This fold is about a centimeter. This fold is where you would grab a real working shade to make it go up or down. But this isn't a real working shade, so this fold is just decorative. Gives you the illusion that it's a working shade. For the final length, I'm making a folded edge just like I did for the top. And it'll look like this. I don't need so much on the back, so I'm just gonna trim it. Okay, now to glue down all the folds. Almost done. I have some stick-on trim from the dollar store. I think this top one is perfect. Stick it to the bottom edge. Look how pretty. Now to glue it on the dowel. Perfect. I have to make an orange one for Blossom. And here it is finished. It's made just like the first one. I made two. I hot glued the magnets directly on the paper. For shades like these, you don't really need a dowel. Next, I'm going to show you how to make a pleated shade. Begin with a folded top edge, just like the other shades, and glue it down. Before you start folding, make sure you have enough room for the dowel or magnets. Now fold it like you're making a fan. Fold, flip it over, fold, flip it over, fold, flip it over, fold, and continue to the end of the paper. And this is what you'll get, a pleated shade. I glued magnets right on the paper. There, so cute! Here are the three shades I made. The magnets make it really easy to change them. This is the window valance that I made for the kitchen. It's really easy to make. This eyelet trim already has a casing. You need a skinny dowel. This dowel is cut a little wider than the window. The trim needs to be 1.5 times the length of the dowel rod. This much. And the dowel just slides right in. This will be held in place with cable clips. There! How easy was that? Next, fabric curtains. These are glued onto dowels with magnets. Fold the top edge down about 1 centimeter. Sew along the edge of the fold right to the other side. Pull the thread, but not all the way. Leave a bit hanging at the end. Turn it around and sew another line going back to where you started. Now you have both ends of the thread on the same side. Hold on to them and push the fabric down to the other end. Look how easy it is to make a ruffle. Mark the middle of the dowel. Place one edge of the curtain at the middle mark. Take the threads to the end of the dowel, and that's where you'll tie the ends of the thread together. Careful not to pull on them. Double check. Perfect. And cut. Now to hot glue this on. Put a dot of glue in the middle. Then another dot. And another until you get to the end. There! The other side is done exactly the same way. The curtain tie is a small hair clip. Add magnets to the dowel like I showed you before. It'll look like this when you're done. It's so pretty. Last one. This cute little valance was cut from the side of the gift bag that I used for the wallpaper. I added a stick-on trim to the top. I glued a longer strip of magnet to the back for more support. And because it's cut from the gift bag, it matches perfectly. Let's have a look at the other rooms. Whoa, don't these curtains look awesome in here? So pretty. Let's turn on the ceiling lights. Wow. They look even better. Alrighty, let's move on to another room. This room is the office. The wallpaper in here is quite bold, so I didn't want the window covering to compete. So I went with the white in the polka dots and made a white pleated shade. The bakery. Look how beautiful this pleated shade is. It goes perfectly with the wallpaper and the butterflies. Last room. The kitchen. The valance looks so cute. It's just so perfect for this kitchen. The window coverings are done, and they look fabulous. See you in part 9 of This Old Dollhouse, when I'll start making furniture. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up. Check out this video.
It's going to be so nice when you get furniture in here.
Yeah, and I can have a party.
I love parties, and we'll have lots of food.
Ooh, we better get baking.
See you again soon.
Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.